Hey guys, welcome back. So guys, in this video we are going to complete how to edit and update the data in Firebase database. Okay guys, so let's get continued with it. So guys, till now we have like how to add the data and fetch the data from the Firebase database. Okay, so these are the things which we are doing with it. Okay, so guys, now we are going to edit the data. So when we will edit this data, you can get it. Okay, so let me go to my table. Where is my table? Okay, so this is my database. Let's call up on real time database. And yeah guys, so there are two datas, okay, with their specific IDs, auto incremented IDs. So those are the datas. So now what we are going to, when we click on edit button, by this specific ID we are going to show the data into a one text box. Okay, so guys, let's get started with it. So we'll get back to the code at index.php file where we have been working. Okay, so this is the edit button. So now what I'm going to tell is over here is, let's create one edit.php file and give colon, and we'll mention this as token is equal to open php close php. Inside this I will echo the auto incremented ID. What ID? This database, these IDs. Okay, so that will be coming through this dollar key thing. So let us call this and paste over here as we have fetched through that database. Okay, done. So now guys, we are going to create edit.php file. So I'm going to create one edit.php file. So in this file I'm going to create a simple form what we have created for the adder. Okay, so this is the form, right? So I'm just going to copy this form and paste into edit file, right? So guys, right now when we click on this first step, we will see that what it is, data is coming. Okay, so edit.php token is equal to the key value should come correctly. So for that first step we will execute this. Now edit, so now the data is coming perfectly. Last is 37, so we'll check. Last is 37, cool. So data is coming fine. So now let us go back and go to insert page. So we will copy this form, okay, so which is already there. So let's hit Control A, Control C and Control V. That's it. And now we'll close this and we will just reload the page once again for this edit page what we have pasted now. So now we are getting this, right? So now what we'll do, we'll just mention this as, change this edit and update data in Firebase database using PHP. Cool. Okay, so guys, now first step we will to get the data by this URL token, we will get this token and then fetch the data into this input box. So guys, let's get started with it. So first step, I'm going to start open PHP and close the PHP. Let's create a variable called token, token token is equal to dollar underscore get method where you are going to get the token. Okay, so using get method we can get the whatever specified token is there. So copy that and get back and paste it over here. So you have fetched that token over here. Not taken, it's token. So now to get that, first you have to connect with the database connection. So for that, let's include the database connection, that is inside the include. So let's call include function to include that database file. So let's call the structure includes folder, inside includes folder db config.php. We have included, and now let's call the a table that is called the referral. Inside this I'm going to call the table that is contact /. Okay, this contact is nothing but your contact table, which is over here, right? So guys, it's done, and now you have to call this token with this referral. Okay, whatever you are going to fetch this token, right? So that we can continue. So let's concatenate and $token token token is set, and now you are going to create one variable called get data or editing data, whatever variable you can create. And first step, we are going to connect the database. So database, what is the database variable what we have set over here? It's database directly. So copy this database, go to your edit page, paste, and get that first referral. Okay, so first we have to get the referral. So you can go to your real retrieving part. So guys, you can, first step is that referral is to get directly over here. So now let's get back referral, get reference. So this is the reference. Now this is the reference, and you can get the child. Okay, so I just want to get the child. Child means that token ID. So you can remove this instead of this one, remove that and get the child one. Okay, so we can use that child. I will show you where it is. Okay, so the snapshot location specified with the relative path. So that is relative path means this ID belongs to this contact, this ID. So through that method we can get it. So let's get child. Get child. So what is the child name over here is nothing but token. So let us copy this token and paste over here. And then what is that? Get value of that token. So get value. So this get value is nothing but it's over here. Okay, returns the contained snapshot. Whatever the snapshot means, getting the value. Okay, so let me save this. And yeah guys, so let us get this and show the data directly over here. So let me minimize this and PHP open close. Let us echo the data as first is username. So let us save and let us test if the username is coming perfectly or what. So guys, let's get back. And yes guys, so username, spelling username is correct. And let us reload the page on edit page. We are there, edit.php. so let us see edit page. Okay, the data is not coming. Why? We will check with that and then we will work with it. Okay, so we didn't paste in the value. So let us type value is equal to, so let us paste over there and let's get back and reload once again. So when you're reloading it, see here guys, so with Prakash is coming fine, correct spelling with Prakash. And let us get the email and phone number also. So let's copy and paste it, not this, let's copy, paste and paste. So this is email and password, done, set guys. And let us reload the page once again, control R. So email and phone number will come. Okay, why is number is not coming, not password, phone. So basic mistakes I'm making it. Load it once again and the data is coming fine. Okay, so let's create one simple cancel button to go back at the index page. So let me copy this and remove name, and instead of button let's make a tag href index.php margin top 3. not 3, will not give margin top, instead of will give HR tag. Save and will give cancel danger. Save. Yeah guys, okay, so when I cancel, it will go back to index page. Okay, so let us go to om@gmail.com, edit that, and it's coming perfect. Okay, so om@gmail.com. now what I want to do, I want to save, update this data, okay, at this same person. So guys, for that let us get back and change some part. So let's tell update data. So guys, here we are going to save, change like update data. Okay, so let us copy this submit button and we'll paste this all thing same. Let's go to code.php. so let us be at code.php file, and this was for the save one. So guys, we will use the same thing, same coding format. Okay, so we are just going to paste it. If some guys is new, please copy this and make some changes whatever we are doing it. Okay, so guys, now let us copy this update button and set to update data, and then the normal fields are same, username, email, phone number, because we copied the same form from the insert data. Okay, so same thing is done, and now let us get back to the code and same data will be proceeded. And now instead of over here, what we are going to add, the token, one extra token. So guys, let's go to our edit page, and after this form tag, I'm just going to create one input tag. Okay, so that input field, input type is equal to hidden, and name is equal to, the name will be as token. Okay, and value is, value is dollar key. Okay, so dollar token, which we are getting from the URL. So let's copy that and paste it over here. Okay, so php echo and paste, done. So this is there, and when you are sending this token, copy this token, go to code.php and create dollar token is equal to dollar underscore post of your input name. Okay, so now this dollar token is there, right? So I'm going to copy this token and add it over here, concatenate it, and then send it to this referral, and then push the, not push, push means saving it. So we have to give update. So for this update function, you can read into this document where we can use the update. So for that, saving data, inside this saving data you can see update specific fields. So you can use the update by referencing it, the by their new post key. Okay, so if you go through those, all these documents, you will understand everything clearly. So I'm just explaining you the correct concept, how we can work with this. So yes guys, so now over here, data updated successfully, data not updated, something went wrong, we will give the status. Okay, let's get back to again index.php. fine guys, so guys, let us test this and see the data is getting updated or not. So let's get back. So once reload the page, so it is Om Prakash. So instead of okay, this is not given as hidden, why, let's make it as HIDDEN hidden. Okay, and let's reload the page. Okay, hidden. So now instead of Om Prakash, I am going to Om N. Okay, and let's update the data. So when I update, it should get updated and one message should come and go to index page. data updated successfully and ohmn is perfect. Okay, set. So now from ohmn to Om Prakash, I will change it once again. Okay, so let us change it back to capital O and Prakash and N, everything, three also. Let's update this and see. So Om Prakash N is getting updated, and let us see over here also, Om Prakash N, it's updated into your Firebase database. So guys, that's nice, and we have completed that how to how to edit and update data in Firebase database using PHP. Okay guys, so thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe, like and share.